The fish is fried to perfect doneness. It's moist, it's the right thickness, and the skin is fried to a perfect crisp. It's very similar to the sort of fry that you would taste perhaps in a Udupi home. A homemaker will always have her ways of doing things. So the prawns have gone into that fried masala now. You're tasting the sweetness of that crab meat juxtaposed against that flavorful aromatic masala. Hi folks, this is Kripal Amana, Gourmet on the Road, and you're watching Food Lovers TV. So today we are on our way to East Bengaluru, more specifically St. Thomas Town. And I've heard of this tiny family eatery that's opened only a couple of months ago, but is doing some interesting things with coastal cuisine. I've learned this is a family enterprise run by a husband and a wife, and they're doing the food of their home and presenting it in this eatery for Bengaluru to savor. So the kind of food that they do, which I'm told is a combination of Mangalorean with a touch of Kerala and coastal, is what caught my attention. And so I thought this afternoon, let's lunch there. So the eatery is called Tarai Coastal Cuisine, and if I'm not mistaken, Tarai means coconut in Tulu. So let's lunch at Tarai, enjoy some delicious food, and hopefully along the way also support this brand new family eatery. Namaskara.
Namaskara. Happy to have you here, sir.
I am happy to be here. I've heard about this place, so I said let me come and see what Tarai.
Yeah, Tarai. Tarai in Tulu means coconut.
So you're Tulu, is it?
Yeah, I'm a Mangalorean. I'm from Udupi.
So I can understand Tulu.
Okay.
Tulu artha apundu.
Okay.
Patere barpuji. Sama barpuji.
Aav malle je. ಹುಟ್ಟಿದೀನಿ ಬೆಳಿತೀನಿ ಪೂರ ಮುಲ್ಪನೆ ಅಂಚ ಅದು ಮಮ್ಮಿಡ ಪಾತೆರ್ ಪಾತೆರ್ದು ಕಲ್ತಿನಾತೆ.
ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಯು ವೇರ್ ಬೋರ್ನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರೇಸ್ಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್
ಅಂಡ್ ಬ್ರಾಟ್ ಅಪ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಲೋರ್
ಇನ್ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ಅಂಡ್ ಯುವರ್ ನೇಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಫ್ರೀಡಾ
ಅಂಡ್ ಯುವರ್
ವಿಜಯ್ ಆನಂದ್
ವಿಜಯ್ ಆನಂದ್
ವೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಯು ಫ್ರಮ್
ಬೋರ್ನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬ್ರಾಟ್ ಅಪ್ ಇನ್ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು
ಬೋರ್ನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬ್ರಾಟ್ ಅಪ್ ಇನ್ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ಯುವರ್ ಡಾಟರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸನ್
ನೋ ದೇ ಕಮ್ ಟು ಸೀ ಯು ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ
ಓ ದೇ ಕಮ್ ಟು ಸೀ ಮೀ ನೈಸ್ ಟು ಮೀಟ್ ಯು ಸೊ ಹೌ ಡಿಡ್ ಯು ಗೆಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಫುಡ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್
ಫುಡ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ ಫುಡೀಸ್ And we love seafood. Then my mom has been a major inspiration to me because she used to make the best coastal items.
Where is your mother from?
Mangalore, Udupi.
Oh, your mother is from Udupi. Okay.
Yeah. So she used to make very good crab, fish and all that. And then I've been so used to eating her food.
She had eventually learned it from her grandmother.
From her grandmom.
So that passed on. Then I thought after I lost her, I thought okay, let me keep up her thing.
Okay.
Cooking and all that.
So I'm told that the food here also has an influence of Kerala to a certain
That's
extent.
That's because my dad's from Kerala.
Okay. Which part of Kerala?
He's from Thrissur.
From Thrissur?
Yeah.
Okay. So that's interesting.
Actually, the fish curry, when you see, Mangalorean, not much of difference because Kerala guys don't use much of coconut in their curry. But Udupi people use lots of coconut.
Correct.
And but when it comes to the tamarind, that is that kodapuli what the
Kokum.
Kerala yeah. That is what mama used to use in her curry. And that gives a very different flavor.
So you got the tarai from Udupi, South Canara.
Yes.
And then you've got the kodampulli from Kerala.
Yeah.
So that goes into the fish curry.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
So that gives a very different flavor, unusual from what you find in the rest of the places.
Basically, my hometown is Rameshwaram.
Rameshwaram?
Yes.
Okay.
From the coastal town of Rameshwaram.
Okay.
But we are the third generation here, settled here.
So is there any contribution from Rameshwaram cuisine to the menu here?
No.
From my side, I only help her out.
So the kitchen is our domain. The kitchen is Frida's domain.
Yes.
Doing a restaurant is always a tough business, right? So have you had some experience in this?
Yeah, my brother used to have a catering. He's into catering from 20-25 years.
Edison, okay.
Edison. So I used to help him out with that.
Uh-huh.
And most of the time in my free time. Then I thought, okay, let me start off something of my own. So I came into this and I wanted to give a recipe which is new to people, you know. I think it's different and everybody who has had so far have liked it. Yeah.
How is business? Are you where you want to be or you want more people coming in?
Yeah, I want people to like my food.
You want more people to come, more people to like your food.
Yes.
Speaking of food, what are some of the special dishes here?
Actually, I make very few, not very huge menu I don't have.
Short menu, I already like the sound of it. So only a few dishes every day.
Okay. In that there's fish curry.
Okay.
And we have all kinds of fishes, whichever is fresh in the market for the day we have.
Okay.
And then we have chicken curry, neer dosa and the ghee roast.
Okay.
Prawn ghee roast,
keema ball curry.
Yeah.
No, keema ball curry is not a typical South Canara thing. So how did that happen?
That was my mom's influence.
Your mom's influence?
Yeah.
From where though?
She used to like it so much, so she used to regularly make it.
Can we take a look at what's happening in the kitchen?
Sure. Fish curry which is made with
kodapuli. Oh, I love that aroma. I can smell the faint whiff of coconut already and that curry leaf. That curry leaf which basically releases all its essential oils as it splutters away in that ugarne. Bangude.
This is a masala made by me here.
Okay.
So we make a masala first, the paste.
Dadgi, chili is one.
Chili, little of methi.
Little methi, You have to have fenugreek. When it comes
to
a fish curry, a Mangalorean fish curry, the fenugreek is very important.
Yes, very
gives it that aroma,
flavor. And then we add little garlic, fresh garlic.
Fresh garlic.
And then little onion. And then we saute this with garlic, fresh garlic, onion, methi, jeera. And then we add
coriander.
And bedige chili and guntur chili mix half and half. I make this powder myself and keep this bedige chili and guntur chili powder.
It's
made fresh.
So is there a proportion of the biyargi to the guntur?
Half I mix.
So the biyargi gives you a nice color. And the guntur gives you that spicy hit.
Yes. This is rasam which goes with the beans. And we have biryani. This is a chicken biryani made by my brother.
Basically Bangalore dum biryani.
Lighter Muslim flavored.
Style.
Muslim style.
Not that hard flavor.
Light, very mellow. So the biryani is made every day.
Yeah. Chicken biryani is made every day. Mutton biryani we have it on Sundays.
On Sundays,
And we have crab.
Denji.
Denji.
Oh, lovely.
This
so the
crab masala.
Crab masala.
Yeah.
So these are those small crabs. So these are the sort of crabs that you need to bite into.
Yeah. Keema ball curry.
Keema ball curry.
Yeah.
I'm already liking the look of that. I can see the keema unde, but I can also see some fat. And it's the fat that gives it that flavor.
Yeah. And this is the kurma what we make, vegetable kurma. This is the brinjal curry.
The brinjal curry. So this is the sear.
Sear fish. And this is the black pomfret. This is the kane.
Malla size tikku ji?
Malla size mulpa tikku na vastu kashta.
So when it comes to the kane, it's always a challenge to get that size. So I think out here we've got one or two specimens which are slightly big, but the others are
normal
of a size that you will typically find in Bengaluru. If you want good kane, you have to go to Sastan. That's because the kane is typically found in the backwater region. It's basically found in the estuaries where the river meets the sea, and that's traditionally the home of the kane.
And this is bangde.
Bangde, and then there's some mackerel as well. I love the fact that the skin of that fish, that mackerel, is shining. When did you buy this fish?
Today morning.
So who goes to the market?
My husband.
Everything is fresh.
Everything is bought in the morning.
Whatever is sold is sold.
Whatever is sold is sold. So you also have the boiled rice.
Yeah, there are lots of people who really like boiled rice. Basically, Mangalore kurva rice.
Kurva rice, which is also used in Kerala. The rice is boiled with the husk. That's why the rice is healthier. So it also has a lot more fiber.
And this is the ghee roast masala, which is already made.
Ghee roast masala.
This again, I fry this methi, little of mustard, little of jeera, and then little of black peppercorns, and then bedige chili and the guntur chili. Making some prawn ghee roast.
Prawn ghee roast.
Roast the ghee.
The ghee, plenty of ghee. I like the size of the prawns. These are medium size.
Yeah, these are medium size.
And how long do you marinate the prawns in the masala?
This is almost an hour now. Just to give that ghee taste to the prawn.
Mm-hmm. And now the masala will roast in that ghee.
Yes.
So that's interesting. So you fry the prawn separately, you fry the masala separately, and then you bring them together.
Yes. The prawn doesn't get cooked too much, but at the same time the masala will be there on it when you fry it this way and put.
A homemaker will always have her ways of doing things. So the prawns have gone into that fried masala now.
Yes.
And this again is your mom's recipe.
Yes.
And where did your mom pick this up from?
This is from her granny.
From her granny.
Granny is supposed to be a very good cook.
And your granny was in Kundapur?
Yeah, Kundapur.
Out here also, you do all the cooking?
Yeah, here I do everything.
All the cooking?
Masalas.
Curries?
Curries are done by me.
Oh, nice.
The sambar, rasam and the veg part, my chef here.
Okay.
Appu.
So Appu has been with you for a while?
He's there from almost 10-15 years.
So you are also now honorary Kundapur. So he's also a part of the family, I suppose. He knows all the recipes, etc. So all the curries are prepared by you, all the masalas are prepared by you, and Appu
helps
you out. And that prawn ghee roast certainly looks quite inviting. You know, when I look at a prawn ghee roast, I want to see that deep reddish brown color with a tinge of yellow that comes from the turmeric. Right, and that's exactly what I'm seeing. I've got the aromas of the curry leaf and also some of that tuppa. This is a dish that I certainly can't wait to taste when I'm at one of the three tables that they have here at Tarai Coastal Cuisine. Buttermilk, black pomfret, prawn ghee roast. Well, I think we should make a beginning, I think, with this buttermilk. Bengaluru is getting into a warm summer. We are only in the beginning of March, but it already feels like we are in peak May already. So therefore, this buttermilk certainly comes in handy. Curry leaf, ginger. This ghee roast, certainly the color and the lushness of the tuppa that I can taste, along with that ogurne of that curry leaf, certainly seems to be a robustly flavored one. Some of that masala first. The first thing that hits you is a bit of tartness that you taste in that masala, which is, I think, the tamarind. And then you have the warmth of the chili. And I'm told out here, Frida uses a combination of the byadgi and the guntur. So the byadgi gives it that color and the guntur gives it that fiery heat. That prawn certainly feels springy to the touch, just the way prawn should be cooked. Cook it too much, tends to be rubbery. I love the texture that the prawn has been cooked to. It's got a slight springy bite. It's moist, it's juicy, and has soaked up all that ghee roast masala. The ghee roast masala here, you have the warmth of the chili, the heat of the chili that you taste. There's also the body of the spices, perhaps some coriander and some of the other ingredients that go in to make that masala. But what you certainly register, first bite on the palate, is the tartness of that tamarind. That's a robustly flavored ghee roast. And you also have a bit of the graininess of the masala that you can feel in the texture of the masala. I think these prawns are cooked just perfectly. We're also doing the kingfish here, and that of course is the crab masala. I think before we go to the fish, I think I want to go back for some more of that prawn ghee roast. I can certainly taste the warmth of the masala on my throat now. Okay, my fish meals are also here. I think I'm going to quickly wrap up my prawn ghee roast. I think the best thing to me about the prawn ghee roast is the manner in which the prawns are cooked. The prawns are cooked textbook perfect. It has a juicy springiness. It has absorbed the masala, but what you're really tasting is also the sweetness of the prawn. And I think what's interesting here is the way in which Frida cooks the prawns. So she cooks the prawns first, makes sure it's fried, just about ready, and then she keeps it aside, and then she roasts the ghee roast masala, and then introduces the prawn to that masala that has been roasted in the lushness of ghee. And therefore that ensures that the prawn doesn't overcook. The prawn is not hard. And that's the sort of prawn ghee roast that you're tasting here. So I think when it comes to a ghee roast, everybody has a different style of making the ghee roast. Even the proportions of ingredient that go into the masala is slightly different. The components will be similar. So you'll have the heat that will come from the chilies. You'll have the robust flavoring of the spices, the coriander and some of the other ingredients that go into make that ghee roast masala. And then you have a bit of tartness that comes from the tamarind. But the proportions may change. So out here I'm tasting the heat of the chili the warmth of the masala, the robust warmth of the masala, but what I'm also tasting is the tartness of the tamarind, which is what you taste on the first bite. So this is a popular offering here, which is a fish meal. So you've got the boiled rice, you've got a fish curry, which is a recipe from Frida's mom. So I'm told this fish curry, of course, has the coconut milk, which is the Udupi Kundapur influence, and then it has a kodampuli that is used as a saring agent. So you've got a mackerel fish head that you get in the curry, and then you get a sambar, you get some cabbage there. You also get a fish fry here. This is the mackerel fish fry, the bangude fish fry. You got a pickle there, you got some papad. I think what we're going to go for next though is some of that fish fry. Black pomfret fish fry. That's a plump piece of black pomfret. The masala in this is napped ever so lightly on the fish. It serves to just add its warming chili flavors to the fish. The black pomfret is a fish that has its own flavors. This is a deep sea fish, and deep sea fish typically tend to be quite dominant in their flavor. What I like here is that skin of that black pomfret has been fried to a perfect crisp. It's also cooked in coconut oil, I think. So you can taste a bit of the coconut oil in the fry. So this isn't a spicy fish fry. This is a fish fry that's quite gentle. You have a bit of the chili that you can taste when some of it hits your throat. But other than that, this is a fish fry that's quite happy, allowing for the flavor of the fish to come through. But if you're tasting this fish fry, taste it before you've tasted that prawn ghee roast. Because once you taste the ghee roast, that robustly flavored masala, it's hard for any ingredient to keep up. And I think that's what's happening here as well. But the fish is again fried to perfect doneness. It's moist, it's the right thickness, and the skin is fried to a perfect crisp. It's very similar to the sort of fry that you would taste perhaps in a Udupi home. And some curry leaf to round off the flavors of that fish fry. Go for some of the rice. I think I'm going to go for some of that curry next. I think this is a fish curry that makes an introduction with a kodampuli on your palate. And that's what I can certainly taste. Let's also get some of that fish head. You know, when it comes to rice, personally for me, and given my South Canara roots, I think the satisfaction that you get from some boiled rice is unbeatable. I think the rice just feels a little fuller on the palate. There's also a little more starch that you taste, and it serves as a perfect medium to hold forth the flavors of a curry like this. That fish curry has soaked up the masala. I suspect if you allow this fish to rest in that masala for a couple more hours, and if they still have some of that fish curry available in the evening, it would speak with a different fervor altogether. The sambar. Anand has got me some sambar as well. But to be honest, I'm so distracted by all the fish curry, fish fry, ghee roast, crab masala that I haven't tasted, the sear fish that I haven't tasted, that I really have to make some effort to look at that sambar and that rasam. I think let's taste some of that kingfish with our fish curry and rice. What I love is the manner in which they fried the fish. That fish is fried perfectly. You want the skin of the fish to be fried to a crisp. And that's what this fish skin that you see here, that is fried crisp, such that it's standing on its own. And then you have the soft crunch of that fish skin. And to me, when I'm tasting fish, that skin is the most precious part of that fish fry. Because the skin is what has all the flavors. And also the fat that is there present in the fish is present closer to the skin. So when you taste the skin, you taste also some of the fat that's roasted to a crisp in the oil, and the flavors of the fish. So when you have a fish fry, don't keep that skin aside. Enjoy that skin with the fish. What I like here, and both the fries that I tasted is that the masala is in the salt that overpowers the character of the fish. The masala is there just to lend support to the flavors of the fish. So you're tasting the masala, of course. You're tasting a bit of the heat that comes from the chilies, a bit of the warmth, a bit of the flavor of the other ingredients that go into that masala. That masala is helping the character, the flavor, the personality of the fish to shine through. That soft crunch of that crispy skin. And also because the masala is cooked to a crisp with the skin, there's also that extra oomph of flavor that you taste of the masala in the fish skin. I think let's taste some of that crab next. This is the crab masala. Some onions in this masala. That's a aromatic and beautifully flavored crab masala. And there's also the fragrance that comes from some jeerige and sauf. And this is a sea crab, and I think it's been caught at the right time, because there certainly is a fair bit of flesh in this crab. You're tasting the sweetness of that crab meat juxtaposed against that flavorful aromatic masala. So first ferret out all the crab meat that you can with your fingers. And what you're tasting in the masala here, in addition to the slight sweetness that comes from the sauf and the jeerige, a little bit of the onion that goes in along with the tomato, is a flavoring of the hard spices. That crab meat has soaked up the masala to its very core. So because they do only few dishes, they do it the traditional way. So this crab has been sitting in that masala for a while, happily soaking up all the flavors of the masala. And when you place that crab in your mouth, that crab readily gives up all those flavors along with the sweet tinge of its fleshy meat. And once you're done prying those little bits that you possibly can with your fingers, it's time to bite into that crab. Bite into the crab, squeeze out every bit of the meat. You don't want to lose any of that meat, because this crab is precious. Precious for a few reasons. Firstly, it's one of those rare specimens of crab that is laden with a lot of flesh, a lot of that sweet, tainted flesh. And secondly, it's prepared to a traditional recipe that's passed on to Frida by her mom. A recipe in which the crab is encouraged to soak up the flavors of the masala. So when you're here, definitely check out that crab masala. When it comes to enjoying crab, you can be squeamish about niceties. When you get a good specimen of a crab, go for it with gay abandon. Don't worry about who's looking, who's watching you from the next table. All that you need to be concerned about is extracting all the flavors of that crab, like I'm certainly trying to do. Time to now take a break from the fish towards the meat, and this is the Keema Unde curry. I've never had a Keema Unde curry in a South Canara meal before, but then I think that's the interesting thing about food. I think food evolves depending on where it goes. So Frida's family has been living here for a long time, so I suppose they have adapted some of their culinary influences to also perhaps what's found here locally. Because if you look at Bengaluru, we love our Keema Unde. We of course also have a tradition that goes back to the Anglo-Indians of the meatball curry. Perhaps that's what came to the military style hotels as the Khaima Unde. And perhaps that's what I'm discovering as the Keema Unde here at Frida and Anand's seafood restaurant. So that Keema Unde is of the texture that readily yields to the lightest of touch. I can see some tomatoes in there, perhaps some coriander as well, I'm not sure. I can definitely see some greens there. I can taste the coriander. So this is not a gutty Keema Unde. This is a sort of Keema Unde that lends itself to being scooped up with that fragile, delicate neer dosa. This is a keema that is quite pasty in its texture. I think there's a bit of flour, gram flour that goes in to hold that keema unde, and I'm certainly tasting a bit of that as well in the flavor that I get on my palate. So I think what's interesting here is that the keema is ground to a mince, but the ingredients like the onions, the tomatoes, etc. are quite coarse. I think that along with the gram flour is what holds that finely ground, almost to a paste mince together. And I can also taste some of the flavor that's rendered from the fat into that gravy. I think the keema curry makes for an interesting dish. If you want to taste a keema unde curry with a Udupi sort of a touch, that's really what this keema unde is all about. A second meaty dish here, which is the chicken curry. What I like here are the consistency of the curries. The consistency of the curry is not thick. This is a sort of curry that your mom would cook for you if you had a Mangalorean mom. You know, these are not those thick, creamy, restaurant-style curries that can sometimes weigh you down. You enjoy it while you're eating it, but then 2 hours later, you're still groaning because your tummy is still bearing the burden of that thick curry. But out here, this is the sort of curry that really transports me back to a home in Kudla. And of course, more neer dosa to go with that chicken curry. I can definitely taste the flavor of the toasted coriander in that chicken curry. What's interesting here as I'm tasting the dishes is that most of the recipes are almost like an open book. Firstly, you can see the ingredients that have gone in. So for instance, I can see some tomatoes here, some onions here, etc. And the ingredients are cooked in a manner that extracts maximum flavor. So as soon as I place that chicken curry in my mouth, I could taste the flavor of the roasted coriander. I'm just trying to visualize this curry had I tasted it in the evening along with that fish curry. When it comes to Mangalorean curries, traditional curries, it's always good to allow for the protein or the meat or the fish to sit in that curry for a while. Having said that, this makes for a tasty, satisfying home style chicken curry. I think time to go for that bangude fry that's sitting on my plate, courtesy the fish meal that it accompanied. And this time I'm going to go for that rice with some of that rasam. That rasam that's been sitting on my thali for a bit. Can I get some hot rasam? So the rasam has a tartness that comes from tamarind, but there's also a hint of sweetness that I'm tasting, perhaps from some jaggery that's gone into that rasam. And I want to taste this rasam hot. Thank you very much. You know, that's a rasam that's worthy. To be drunk. You know, sometimes you enjoy a big meal and you want that something that will seal the deal. And this rasam is certainly a fine specimen of that. With its tart flavors that comes from the tamarind, the tomato, and that sweetness that comes from the bella or the jaggery. When you pour rasam over rice, to me the rule is pour so much that the rice is literally swimming in that rasam. Because you need more of that rasam to hold on to its flavors. And that's where that bangude fry, the mackerel fry, will also come in. Of course, the fish is slightly cold because it's sitting on my thali for a while. But that fish is plump. I think a tad shy in the spicing of the masala. Because I think when it comes to the bangude is a robustly flavored fish. If you were to look at the flavors of various fish, from the black pomfret to the sear and then your mackerel or the bangude, the bangude's flavors far outpower the other fish, and therefore I think sometimes you need a masala too that's able to hold itself against that fish fry. I think out here the masala, having worked beautifully well with the other fish fries, is struggling to keep up with the vivacious fish laden flavors of that mackerel. I think let's taste some of that sambar. That's a tasty sambar that serves to get rid of any guilty pangs along with that cabbage. In case you feel you've overindulged in the fish and the mutton and the chicken, I think that's where that sambar along with that cabbage plays a role. It's a tasty cabbage palya. Also ensures that you get your fiber as part of this fish meal.
the
dal paisa. Dal paisa. I've had the fish meal. I've had the black pomfret. I've had the sear fish. I've had the chicken curry, the crab masala, the keema undi. I've had the prawn ghee roast, that bangda curry. I think I still have some space for a dal paisa. I like the paisam, not too sweet, but with a tad of indulgence that comes from the raisins and the cashew that are lightly roasted with some ghee. And that's what elevates the appeal of otherwise a rather simple but pleasing dessert. Well, I've enjoyed my meal here at Tarai Coastal Restaurant here in St. Thomas Town in East Bengaluru. The eatery is only 2 months old, but it's already made an impression on my palate. That crab masala is a must eat, especially if you like your denji. That ghee roast too is interesting, and I love the manner in which they fry the fish. The fish is fried to textbook perfection with just the right nape of the masala, allowing for the flavors of the fish to shine. The dishes here are the sort that you would taste in a home in Udupi or Kundapur, and rightfully so, because most of the dishes here are Frida's ode to the recipes of our late mother, Jessie. So if you're looking to taste some delicious home-style coastal food, definitely find your way to Tarai Restaurant here in East Bengaluru. It's a tiny eatery serving only a smattering of dishes, all prepared fresh for the day. But it's the sort of flavors that will leave a big impression on your palate. I hope you found this episode interesting, and also find it in your heart to support eateries like these. They need all the support and all the assistance that they can get. Until the next time, take care, stay safe, and happy eating. If you'd like to support the work that we do at Food Lovers TV, do consider joining our membership community on YouTube by hitting the join button below or on the homepage. You could pledge a nominal sum and receive special privileges like behind the scenes footage, shoot updates, access to live Q&As, and a lot more. You could support us on a Patreon page as well. For more info, check out the links in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and leave a comment below. Happy eating!